They're all right and pretty happy on the other side, especially Brandon. Brandon needed some help getting over there. He was having a hard time coping with it, but he's okay now. But who's else? Okay, something else too. This is something that's been popping in the mind. Is he right here? And, this is something that keeps coming to mind. That something happened that I think it's the Golden Food Market on JD. I think it was there. It's a case where I saw in the news where this guy came in to rob a store. His name is James or something like that. The guy came in to rob the store, but the customer in the store ended up shooting the guy, this guy James, you know? And I've been, you know, I just want to say what's up to you, Jay, man. I've been seeing you. I finally remember to mention it. He's been coming through for a minute, you know?
Yeah.
You see him? He wants to talk, you know. He just.
I think I see the guy. Yeah.
He has kids and that he left behind. He's having a hard time, you know. He just needed to talk. He just needs to know people to know that he's all right.
Yeah.
He's not in some hell. He's not being punished. He's adjusting to his new life. And anything else that I want coming up? Yeah. This is another one. I can't remember his name. It's a little young dude. With a basketball. I see his gravestone, but I can't make the name out. He's got a basketball on his gravesite. You see him, a little young boy with a hat on. What's his name? The beginning? Is it Jay? I have it in my book. I've seen him before.
I was getting a CH sound.
CH, somehow.
I don't know.
He's a young boy, and he has a basketball. He's showing his grave. It has a basketball on it, on his gravestone. He is maybe 16 years old from Richmond. And I've seen him before. If y'all know what I'm talking about, it's a young, short, young dude, kind of light-skinned, fairly light-skinned. And I wish I could remember the name. I'm not getting the whole name, but...
Never did it right.
I have a name, but I remember it before, but... He's coming through to his people saying hello. He's bouncing a basketball. You know, he loved to play basketball. He was a basketball player. I think I'm getting that he went to John Marshall. You know, that's what's coming through psychically. But whoever it is, he's all right. Well, then, if you need help talking to him, we'll put you through to him. He's been wanting to come through. And anything else before we close out? Let me open my mouth. If you see anyone. Let me see if anyone else pops through in my mind here. I see quite a few, but I wanted to say, all right, Talik. You know,
yeah.
Those of you who know him from Powhatan, believe me, he's all right. You know, he comes through here and there. You know, he's a good dude.
Edward or Everett or whatever his
name is. Everett, dude.
He went to on camera, you know.
Hey, you see him now, too.
Yeah.
Everett, man, I'm glad I know you're feeling better now, aren't you?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Thumbs up to that, man. You know, all right, good, thanks for coming through, too, man. Shouts out to Everett from Baltimore, Maryland.
Yeah,
you know, love you, man, you know. Thanks for coming through.
Good to see you, yeah.
And anyone else? You see anyone that we got them? You know, we talked about Leek, you know, he's saying hello, and we'll leave it at that, I guess, you know. Keep the questions coming. Send them to Facebook or call us with them. Leave them as comments on Facebook, or if you want to write us privately, write a private message. And don't be afraid to call back, because, like, look, it's our job. We want to talk to you. We want to help.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes the stuff that you hear is going to be hard to hear. That's a warning, you know. But it can be hard to hear, but it's worth it. You know, it's worth, the message is worth it in the end, even if it's tough to listen to. Because they're not always going to say what you want to say. You can say that before we close. Sometimes the message you're going to get from these guys isn't exactly what you're going to expect. Yeah. You know, sometimes it's not anything like you expect it to be, but it's always for the best. And, you know, it reminds me of the day we did the Everett dude. You know, Everett, we took you over that night driving home after that. All I saw was Maryland license plates everywhere. All I thought was Maryland this, Maryland that. Every license plate I kept seeing was Maryland.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and I knew that was him, you know. I could feel you, brother. I could feel you there. But, you know, he was happy. That's what I kept getting.
Absolutely.
This is what keeps me going. When I make your spirit happy, when I help make people here happy, well, especially when we cross over these lost souls, like Everett or some of these other guys, you know, like it makes them feel so much better. That Jay dude from Maryland Avenue in Richmond, you know, they died on his porch, right? You know, that one, he was so angry and bitter. And then he crossed over and it made him feel a lot better. So, you know, that keeps me going. That makes me happy in life to know that they're all right. But we're going to close here for now. And we hope the best as always for all of you. And if you have any questions or any complaints, even if you don't feel something we did was right, you know, write us. You know, we're not going to get upset. We want to hear the truth.
Yeah, please do.
Write the truth. Don't hide from the truth. Even if it seems funny or wrong, don't hide from the truth. Don't sugarcoat it. You know, let it be real. I like that song. That song just popped in my mind out of nowhere. It's like a rap song called Be Real. I think it's that little short dude from Atlanta did it. Little Scrappy, that's his name. There's a song called Be Real. If you thug or something, be real. If you're a hustler, something like that, be real, be real. It's something like that. I've heard the song.
Yeah.
It just popped in my mind for some reason.
Be real.
Be real is important. And that song, for some reason, has significance to someone watching this. Because that came to mind. In fact, I can see that dude, and I can see a dude for him. I can see one of his friends who died. See, we can do anybody. It doesn't matter who it is. You know, we're sitting here talking about someone down in Atlanta who's famous, but we can see his people.
Yeah.
I see a young dude coming through for him. We do whatever. You know, once you open up, you can do anything. But we're going to close it. We got 2 minutes, 3 minutes, actually.
Well, I got
you're going to go. I'll talk while you do it, right?
Yeah.
You know, forgive us for just running around saying a lot of stuff. But, yeah, we could do anybody. Like, we're sitting here talking about Lil Scrappy and his song. The very moment we said his name, poof, 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 poof. You know, and I said our spiritual vision, there comes the spirits for him, people he knew. You know, one time we were talking about Lil Wayne and something. Someone asked about him. Someone talked about Soldier Swim or something. And he just popped on through, and Lil Wayne's dad was popping through. We could see all his people. Anytime there's an opening, that the spirits can see it, and they'll come. So don't matter who it is or where you are, locally or non-local, they know it. You know, so we're just here to be of service. I'm going to talk a little more because we have 2 minutes. Jeremy's still waiting on his ride. After this, I'm headed home. I'm going to make some lunch and get these videos on the computer. I'm sitting here next to the phone. Jeremy's there. We are at 18 minutes and 30 seconds. I was just telling them about, like, you know, that time, like, Chrissy and I, her son are talking about Lil Wayne, and then her husband talked about this dude, Soldier Slim, like that new Lil Wayne, and then somebody had murdered him, and then they all were popping through that day as we talked about them.
Yeah.
I could see Lil Wayne's dad who crossed over. I could see the Soldier Slim dude, and plus a bunch of young dudes who I had no idea who they were, but they knew him. Right. So it's the same way that little Scrappy dude had people wanting to talk to him. You know what I'm talking about. I'm saying that famous or not famous, we can do anything.
They all pop through.
They want to talk bad. They want. All these guys want to talk that, you know. Maybe one day we'll run into Lil Wayne and Lil Scrappy and all of them. Probably will.
Usually everybody has a spirit that they want to get in contact with.
They have a bunch, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
Lil Wayne's dad comes through all the time. Every time I talk about him, I kind of see that dude. He wants to talk. I think that maybe when his dad died, it affected Wayne a lot. That's what I'm getting.
Right.
It fucked him up in the head. It messed things up.
Right.
You know, I think he probably would like to hear from him. But we'll see what happens in our future. We'll probably end up meeting some of these people, you know. But anyway, we're going to close off for here. Peace be with you.
Peace.